That is the bonda soup.
Bonda soup. Oh, yeah. That looks very nice.
The soup looks quite mild, but with the pepper and the green chili, it does pack some heat. You know, like in any kitchen that's run by resourceful people, especially women, you find some of the ingredients across the various dishes. So I can see the chawli there, the alsante kalu, and I think I can also spot some in my saute kai palya. If you love milk and you love the creaminess of milk, this is certainly a dessert for you to savor. Lunch open. I was in Mysuru and they said you have to eat at Mahesh Prasad. Namaskara.
Finally, you landed up into Mahesh Prasad.
Thank you very much, sir. Are you from here?
Yeah, I'm from here. I'm the manager of this hotel.
Oh, very nice. What's your name, sir?
Muralidhar Acha.
So normally, the breakfast in the morning, so like idli, vada, sambar, kesari bath, that is fine. Again, lunch is very popular here. So people are coming all over from here, Mysore.
And how old is this place, sir?
This is 20 years.
ಮತ್ತೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಊಟ ಯಾವ ತರ ಊಟ ಇದು?
ಇದು ಸೌತ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಮೀಲ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ.
ಸೌತ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಮೀಲ್ಸ್ ಬರ್ಬೋದು ಅವಳಿಗೆ?
ಬರ್ಬೋದು. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಬೋಂಡಾ ಸೂಪ್.
ಬೋಂಡಾ ಸೂಪ್. ಓ, ದಟ್ ಲುಕ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ನೈಸ್.
ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಸೌತ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಮೀಲ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಸರ್ವ್ ವಿತ್ ಸಾಂಬಾರ್, ರಸಂ, ಕೂಟು, ಬಟರ್ ಮಿಲ್ಕ್, ಕರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪಾಯಸಂ.
And this is like what, sir? It's a South Canara style of a...
We are from my South Canara.
Oh, you're from South Canara?
We're all from my South Canara. The boss is South Canara.
Oh, what's your boss's name, sir?
It's K. Prakash Shetty.
Again, what's your full name, sir?
My name is Muralidhar Acha.
Muralidhar?
Acha.
Acha. Yeah. So, you're from Mangalore now, right?
Yeah, all Mangalore.
If I say it once again, what Mangalore has done in terms of contributing to the culinary landscape of this country, I know some of you will say I'm very biased towards Mangalore, but...
Still it is.
That is a fact.
Yeah, food department, if you go for anywhere, it is a Mangalore.
Either on... Mr. Acharya said that, not me.
Yeah, definitely. This is, we call it as the executive lunch.
Executive lunch.
Yeah. So we did limited food. There is a curry, there is a dal, there is a curd rice, there is a two rotis, some special rice. And we have small salad in that. Any type, different type of top. And banana.
And banana.
Yeah.
And nice to see ladies here. Are
We work lot of ladies here.
Oh, very
they
nice.
Work hard actually. Ladies are the best.
Fantastic. But the taste of the ladies.
Yeah.
Allah?
They give.
Adu onnu bere irutte. Mane tara, amma maadi tara irutte.
This is good.
Fantastic. So are some of your cooks also ladies?
Some of the cooks. Two cooks are there.
They're
on the shift. And these people do everything. Coffee, idli, rava, idli, everything they do it.
Very nice. So I think we are here for lunch. But next time now breakfast ಸಿಗೆ ಸಹ ಬರಬೇಕು
ಆ ಥರ ಅನ್ಸುತ್ತೆ ನನಗೆ. ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಮಾ. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು. Is that bonda soup very popular?
Yeah, very popular it is.
I'm here only for the last 5 minutes. All this, I've seen 3 bonda soups going on.
People like that. People like after 11 o'clock, it start moving it. Up to 8 o'clock in the night.
I think I'm going to taste the thali, but I think I will also probably make some space for that bonda soup. Chanage de adu.
So we have a small room like family to come and sit. So this is one place, that is one place. It is like a homely atmosphere.
Correct. It was actually originally it was a house or something, is it?
Actually it is a house.
Oh.
We have last 3 years back we renovated. It was like a house only.
So that's the feeling that one gets, you know, it has a very homely sort of vibe.
Yeah.
Even in the kitchen when you watch there, the staff, some of the ladies out there, also the kitchen is very clean, very spread out. Calm is there.
Calm.
You know, I love the atmosphere in some of these places that have been preserved through a passage of time. And it's not easy to preserve places. It's quite easy to demolish and build something new. But to sustain and preserve, especially structures like these, is not easy. And the nice thing is when you dine in places like these, it carries you back to the comforting feeling of yesteryear. And I think that's always a nice thing. When you sit down for a meal, the food should not just nourish you, sustain you, but should also comfort you in a manner of speaking. And I think spaces like these do that.
Yeah.
Right? ಬೋಂಡ ಸೂಪ್ ಇಂದ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡೋಣ. ಓಕೆ ಸರ್. ಒಂದು ಸೌತ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಮೀಲ್ ಕೂಡ ಮಾಡೋಣ. ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಬೋಂಡ ಸೂಪ್, ಒನ್ ಬೋಂಡ ಸೂಪ್. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ವೆರಿ ಮಚ್. ನಿಮ್ಮ ಹೆಸರು ಸರ್?
ಸರ್ ನಾಗರಾಜು.
ನಾಗರಾಜು, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ವೆರಿ ಮಚ್. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ವೆರಿ ಫೇಮಸ್ ಬೋಂಡ ಸೂಪ್. ಐ ಎಮ್ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲರ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ 11 AM. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬೋಂಡ ಇಸ್ ಫ್ಲೋಟಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ನರಿಶಿಂಗ್ ಸೂಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಮ್ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಮ್. ಪ್ಲೆಂಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಟೊಮೆಟೋಸ್ ಇನ್ ದೇರ್, ಸಮ್ ಕರಿ ಲೀಫ್ ಟು ಐ ಸಪೋಸ್, ದೇರ್ ಅ ಮಸ್ಟರ್ಡ್ ಸೀಸನಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಇಟ್, ಸಮ್ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಚಿಲ್ಲಿಸ್ ಇನ್ ದೇರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಗುಡ್ ಮೆಷರ್. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ದಾಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಾಟ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಸೂಪ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಐ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಸೇ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ರಾದರ್ ನರಿಶಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್. ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದ ಫ್ಲೇವರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಮ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಯು ಬೈಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಸಮ್ ಪೆಪ್ಪರ್ ಟು. I can taste some pepper there, and of course the fleshiness of the tomatoes. There's plenty of pepper in that broth.
Basundi chandrara sweet.
Oh, sweet kuda idaya.
Basundi chandrara jamun.
He's saying all the nice things.
This one basundi cold.
Basundi cold.
Chandrara hot.
Chandrara hot. Chandrara lan try madidane. But I think a basundi we haven't done in a long time. And perhaps a gulab jamun. Adu uta admele alla. ಊಟ ಆದ ಮೇಲೆ. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು. ಅ ಡೆಸರ್ಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಪಾಪ್ ಟು ಮೈ ಮೈಂಡ್, ಬಟ್ ಈ ಸೆಟ್ ವಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದ ಚಂದ್ರಹಾರ, ದ ಬಾಸುಂದಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಗುಲಾಬ್ ಜಾಮೂನ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಐ ಸೆಟ್ ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಿ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಆಫ್ ದೆಮ್, ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಸೋ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕೆನ್ ಟೆಲ್ ಯು ಮೋರ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ವಾಟ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಆಫರ್ ಯು, ನಾಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಮೀ, ಫಾರ್ ಯು ಔಟ್ ದೇರ್. ಉದ್ದಿನ ಬೋಂಡ ಸೋಕ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ನರಿಶಿಂಗ್ ಲೆಂಟಲ್ ಬ್ರಾತ್. Very comforting at that. Of course the bonda doesn't have any crunch at this point in time because it's been sitting in that for a while, so the lentils have seeped into it completely, but I just bit into the crunch of some ginger. It's the warmth of some ginger. The soup looks quite mild, but with the pepper and the green chili it does pack some heat. This is delicious, and I love the fleshy crunch of the coconut that I bite into every once in a while in that bonda. Such a wholesome start to lunch here at Mahesh Prasad. And there you can see a peppercorn make its presence visible to the eye, and also its warmth, its peppery warmth on the tongue. It was a great start. How was the food?
Tasty.
Are you regulars here?
Yeah.
Are you from Mysuru?
We are from
KR Nagara. How far? Very far?
50 kilometers.
Enjoy your meal. Nice to meet you. Some jeerige from the soup that's giving me company even as I wait for my thali. Well, we have our South Indian thali here. Let's make some space on the thali. I've got some chapati here. We have a dessert, very important part of a good thali in my books. You have some mosuru to finish the meal, some buttermilk. This is a vegetable preparation. This, I'm told, is the Mangalurdu Sautekai. Some rasam and some sambar. And we also have a beetroot vegetable right here. Quite tasty, quite wholesome. The chapati is nice and soft, and I think will make for a good scoop to savor the beetroot palya. I can see some mentsankai in that. Looks like the Guntur mentsankai. You have the earthy sweetness of the beetroot and the fleshy bite of the coconut. Also some tempering of the uddana bele, I think. I never used to be a big fan of beetroot earlier, but over a period of time I'm quite beginning to enjoy its fleshy bite and also its mild earthy sweetness. There's also some pulses here. That's a tasty beetroot palya. Let's turn back to that sautekai. You know, like in any kitchen that's run by
resourceful people, especially women, you find some of the ingredients across the various dishes. So I can see the chawli there, the alsande kalu, and I think I can also spot some in my sautekai palya. Some jeerege too in that. The place is getting busy, and from the looks of it, when you come here during peak time, it's quite common to share tables. I have a feeling this is the bottle gourd, not the Mangalore sautekai, as was told to me by our server. It's quite firm to be a sautekai. Whatever it is, makes it a tasty vegetable preparation. Some buttermilk. There's a tinge of some curry leaf in that. And let's go to the anna. First with some sambar. And that's a soppu sambar. Some greens in there. And some sprouts too, I think. Bisi there. When you touch your sambar, bisi irbeko. That sambar powder, the sambar masala is certainly quite aromatic. I can also taste a bit of hingu, some of the asafoetida in there. There's also the crunch of the onions somewhere amidst the soppu. So this is an unlimited meal. When it comes to the sambar, the rasam, the palya, also that beetroot. The rest of the things are limited when it comes to the rice, the chapati, the dessert, or the yogurt. So I portioned this rice out just for the rasam, but I think I'm not done with the sambar yet. That sambar is quite tasty. There's plenty going on in this sambar. You got the greens, of course, and then you have some sprouts in there. Not able to place a finger on what exactly, but I think it's some green gram, if I'm not mistaken. Makes for a tasty, flavorful scoop of rice. So the family that took over this establishment came from Mangaluru. The manager too is from Mangaluru. But he said that our roots are there, but the tastes of the dishes here are local in nature. And I can certainly find that in this sambar. So typically, in a Mangalorean sambar, there will be a slight tinge of sweetness somewhere there. But in this one, what I'm tasting is the flavor of the garam masala, of the sambar masala. Some more rice, this time with the rasam. You have the tartness from the tomato, and I think also some puli, from the puli or the tamarind. I'm also tasting somewhere the coriander in that rasam powder. And that's where the papad, the happada, comes in handy. Some uppinakai too. Then some masuru, anna. We've tasted many of these vegetarian thalis, and even as we were contemplating visiting here and I did some research on the kind of food that they do for lunch, it seemed very similar to some of vegetarian meals that we've done in the recent past. But the interesting thing always is that although the components may be the same, you'll have a sambar, you'll have a rasam, you'll have a dry sabzi, you'll have a gravy vegetable, you'll have the buttermilk, the yogurt, etc., etc., the flavors in most of these components will usually vary. And that's exactly what I'm finding in this South Indian thali here at Mahesh Prasad. Although their roots are from Mangalore, but the flavors, I think, have been adapted to what goes well with the palates of the locals. Some mentsan ka in that pickle. You're expecting to bite into some chili spice, but nah, none of that. That chili is puckeringly sour. I think we should get to our dessert. The dessert that comes with the thali. I think that's the chana dal, if I'm not mistaken, with some sabbaki. I can taste the flavor of some cardamom in that. Tiny katori of the paisam, but just right to seal the deal or to wrap up your meal. This is a chandrahara. This is also a dessert that's made popular by Mawaldi Tiffin Room in Lalbagh. So basically, this is a pastry that's made of some maida, some semolina, etc. that is deep fried and then served to you in a reduced milk syrup of sorts that's fortified with plenty of nuts and sugar. So this is a dish that I have tasted at Mavali Tiffin Room, and I'm told this was a dish that was invented by them decades ago. If you haven't caught that episode where I tasted the Chandrahara there, I'm going to place a link in the description below. And yes, that dough also has plenty of ghee, and that's what you're definitely tasting. That's not any ordinary pastry, that's a pastry that's fortified with plenty of ghee. But it's also a dessert that borders on being cloyingly sweet, especially this version here. So if an overtly sweet dessert isn't your thing, you should probably stick to that parappu payasam that I enjoyed with my South Indian thali. So that basundi is finally here. Some chironji that you have floating on top. If you love milk and you love the creaminess of milk, this is certainly a dessert for you to savor. The milk is cooked on a low flame with nuts, allowed to reduce for a fair bit before it's fortified with sugar and perhaps some cardamom powder just to impart it a bit of flavor. There's a pistachio in there, the cashew, the badam. So it's got all the good things, including the milk. I love the creaminess of this dessert. And it's chilled just perfect. Also, the cream doesn't overwhelm your palate. And the sweetness to this basundi is just perfect. We were driving through Mysuru and we had heard about Mahesh Prasad. But in all my previous trips, I haven't had the opportunity to dine here. So today we made it a point to stay back in Mysuru for lunch, to savour their South Indian thali, that bonda soup, and also now this basundi. And I must say, I'm happy we chose this opportunity to check out Mahesh Prasad. I've enjoyed my lunch here, and needless to say, I'm already making plans to return here for breakfast. I think Mahesh Prasad is all about old-fashioned goodness in the food that they serve, in the manner in which they serve, in the atmosphere of this beautiful old home that you savor your meal in. I hope you've enjoyed this episode of Gourmet on the Road. Until the next time, take care, stay safe, stay strong, and happy eating. If you'd like to support the work that we do at Food Lovers TV, do consider joining our membership community on YouTube by hitting the join button below or on the homepage. You could pledge a nominal sum and receive special privileges like behind the scenes footage, shoot updates, access to live Q&As, and a lot more. You could support us on a Patreon page as well. For more info, check out the links in the description below. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and leave a comment below. Happy eating!